All right, I'm going to ask the mentors to introduce our persons, and we'll do it in alphabetical order by last name, which means Joe, you're first. Not because Joe's first, but because Dwayne is first.
Okay. It's truly an honor and a pleasure to be asked to be a presenter.
If there's anybody in the other room, they need to have it, so.
Okay, the other room. It's an honor and a pleasure to be asked to be a presenter of Mr. Bob Dwayne. He is transferring his membership from the Orono Methodist Church in Orono, Maine. He has served on many different committees at the church, at the previous churches, Pastor Paris, SPCRC, the trustees. He also, taught Sunday school there also. He's married, he has five children, two boys and three girls, one grandson and another grandchild on the way. Things you don't know about him, he's previously owned his own business. He was into electronics, fixing them. He also served in the Army for 3 years, and for that I want to thank you for your service. It's an honor to know that. So that's about all I got. And I will torture you.
As the spouse of the current pastor, I just want to say that it's not always a given that the pastor's spouse joins the congregation of that's being served by that pastor. I know a lot of people that are colleagues of Pat's, their spouses don't go to the church that that their spouse is the pastor of. In my case, I chose to join the Church on the Cape for primarily two reasons. One is because of the deep spirituality that I see here, and also because of the commitment to mission work that goes on every day throughout this congregation. So thank you.
Thank you. Would you pass it to Carol, please?
I would like to introduce Barb Miller. She and her husband moved to Wells last fall from Pennsylvania. And the reason they did was so that they could be closer to their children. She has three sons. The oldest is married and lives in Portsmouth with a little girl. The middle one is up in Portland working, and the third one is still in Pennsylvania in college. She is transferring from the Grace United Methodist Church in Lewistown. But she is a native Mainer. She is raised in Aroostook County. She has degrees in art and nursing from the University of Maine, but then she pursued a career in midwifery. New word for me, where she had received certificates and a master's in that vocation, and she's worked for 25 years before she retired. And she has interests in gardening, and she's already joined the garden club with us here in the community. So we're so glad to have you join us.
Thank you so much. When I was asked to talk about why I decided to become a member of this church, thought about it and decided that there's actually multiple reasons. The first one is simply nostalgia. This sanctuary reminds me of the little country churches that I attended as a child in Aroostook County 50 years ago. So it feels home-like. The second reason is because this congregation is blessed with extraordinarily gifted musicians. The music here is frequently transcendent, and I would come to the services for no other reason than just for the opportunity to hear the organ and the violin, and this morning the woodwind. The third reason is because I came here at about the same time that Pastor Pat came here as your new pastor, and I have been fortunate enough to get to know her a little bit. I think she is a remarkable woman, and she is a joy to know. And again, I would come here just because Pastor Pat is here. The final and most important reason to me, though, is that when my husband and I made the decision to move here, I actually did an internet search and looked for a church that seemed to have a lot of interest in providing service and reaching out to the wider community beyond the sanctuary doors. And the website for this church seemed to offer those opportunities, and when I came here, I was not disappointed. So the main reason I am here is because I hope to help you all change the world.
Thank you. Debbie.
It is with much joy that I'm introducing new member Sandra St. Jean to all of you this morning. As many of you know, Sandy is the daughter of Alice Roy Bruton and has visited Church on the Cape many times over the past years. Sandy was born in Massachusetts and grew up in Braintree. Her college years earned her a degree in computer science. Sandy is married to Jerry St. Jean, whom she met at the Stop and Shop in Quincy, where he's still working. They settled in Rentham and raised two children, Danielle and Andrew, who have visited Church on the Cape many, many times in their growing up years. After being a stay-at-home mom while her children were young, Sandy began working at Bryant University as an admissions assistant for a number of years. When the opportunity to retire presented itself, both children were into adulthood, and Alice and Roy had been living in Kennebunkport for a number of years. A decision was made to move to Maine, and the St. Jeans found a condo in the woods, as many of you are. This change of address brought Sandy closer to her mom and dad and nearer to the church on the Cape. Sandy described the move and the emotional feelings as if she were coming home. We welcome you home.
New member class, Pat asked us to go around the table and say one word that came to mind about the Church on the Cape. And I didn't even have to think about it. And I wasn't going to cry. The word is family. And for the obvious reasons, mom and dad are here, have been here a long time. But living a couple of hours from them has been tough, and I can't even describe the peace of mind that I have had knowing that their church family was caring for them when we couldn't be here because of family and work obligations. So no doubt in my mind that this is the place where I wanted my church family to be. So I thank you all for many, many years of your love for my parents, and I'm looking forward to many years of the way that you will embrace my family, my husband, and my children. And like Debbie said, I do feel like it's coming home. And I do. This is where I would like my church family to be. Although I think it's been here all along. We just made it official today.
Not quite yet.
Getting there.
Okay, a couple of questions for Barb and Bob and Sandy. As members of Christ's Universal Church, will you be loyal to the United Methodist Church and do all in your power to strengthen its ministries? As members of this congregation, will you faithfully participate in its ministries by your prayers, your presence, your gifts, your service, and your witness? members of the household of God, page 38. I commend these persons to your love and care. Do all in your power to increase their faith, confirm their hope, and perfect them in love. And we welcome you in Christian love. As members together with you in the body of Christ and in this congregation of the United Methodist Church, we renew our covenant faithfully to participate in the ministries of the church by our prayers, our presence, our gifts, our service, that in everything God may be glorified through Jesus Christ. May the God of all grace, who has called us to eternal glory in Christ, establish and strengthen you by the power of the Holy Spirit, that you may live in grace and peace. Welcome to the church. Let's sing verse 5. We are the work of God's hands, the psalmist says, and God continues to shape us each and every day. We bring our gifts this morning because we are part of creating this world through the ministry of this church and the witness of our lives. So let's gather our gifts together and present them as an offering before God.
Thank you. Oh,